Hi everyone, just a stranger here. This is my first video, so I hope I won't be judged too harshly. So I want to talk about how I got my first coding job, and this was during the pandemic. I graduated from a boot camp on November of 2019. I'm not going to say what that boot camp is called. A little bit about myself. I used to teach 7th grade ELA in a public school. I was sold this dream that as a female and Asian, I would have a much easier time getting a job in this already saturated field of developers. So I kind of like went into job search thinking that what I have on the resume, which was basically projects that I did during the boot camp, would be enough. But it wasn't the case for me. I slowly realized that my resume was shit. You want to make sure that you continue to work on projects even after you graduated from bootcamp, because interviewers or companies, when they look at your resume and they don't see that you have work experience, they can only, you know, base your knowledge off of the projects that you have on your resume and also on GitHub. So you want to make sure that you continue to work on projects and that these projects are pushed to GitHub and they're made public so that they can, you know, clone them and check it out. There were a couple of times when the interviewer told me that they were interested in me because of this specific project that I worked on. So this is why I feel that working on projects is like really important. So after I felt comfortable with my resume and my GitHub page, I started to apply for jobs, and I use Indeed and LinkedIn for my job search. I basically apply for every job posting there is in the United States, and the reason is because even though that company may not be in my state, I still wanted that interviewing experience. I wanted to know what questions they'll ask. Also wanted to know how I will react to questions that I am not prepared for. These interviewing experience made me realize that I should have a document that contained the questions that I was asked and also some responses that I could say. And I would keep on like adding to this document, also would keep on editing the responses. And this really helped improve my interviewing skills because I am quite prepared for anything that they asked me. I also connected with people who graduated from the same bootcamp as me and were working in the company that I was interested in on LinkedIn. And this really helped because they told me how the interviewing process is like, how it's like working at the company. They also gave me a referral, and a referral really helped me by a long shot. It was almost like a guarantee interview for me. How I connected with the people that graduated from the same bootcamp as me is like I would find them on LinkedIn, and then I would add them but also send like a note to them. Something like, hi, my name is, and I recently graduated from this bootcamp, and ask if they have some time where you can ask some questions about the interviewing process, the company, you know, things like that. So I added a lot of people who graduated from my bootcamp, and I was surprised that, well, first there were a lot of people who did ignore me, but there were also a lot of people who did take the time to do like half an hour to an hour long phone calls with me answering any questions I had, as well as like giving their tips for interviewing, for job searching, which is very helpful for me. I'm hearing it from people who went through the same experience as me and getting like this affirmation and encouragement from them really, you know, lifted my spirits. One other thing that I tried is sending cover letters to companies that I was really interested in, and how I got the email address is using this extension called Clearbit Connect. I used it with Google Chrome. I don't know if it works for other browsers, but basically for this extension, you can type the company that you're interested in, and then it'll give you a list of people who work there, as well as their email addresses. It also tells you, like, you know, what position they have, so it can be like CEO, hiring manager, etc. So you can pick and choose who you want to email.